Today we are going to discuss the concept of agonist, antagonist, partial agonist and inverse agonist. For that we should know what is mean by affinity and intrinsic activity. Affinity means ability of drug to bind with the receptor. What is affinity? Ability of drug to bind with the receptor. And intrinsic activity means ability of drug to produce conformational changes in the receptor to produce pharmacological responses. So based on the affinity and intrinsic activity, we have to differentiate this agonist, antagonist, partial agonist and inverse agonist. So how will you define this agonist? Agonist is the drug, or it may be a hormone, or it may be a neurotransmitter, or it may be just a ligand. So this agonist have capability to bind with the receptor. Agonist have capability to bind with the receptor, and it has also capability to produce conformational changes in the receptor. Agonist is having affinity, that is plus one, and intrinsic activity is also plus one. What does that mean? This agonist is having ability or capability to bind with the receptor, that means affinity is plus one, and it has also capability to produce conformational changes in the receptor to produce pharmacological responses. That's why intrinsic activity is also plus one. So what are the various examples of agonist? As I told you, agonist, it may be a hormone, it may be a neurotransmitter, it may be any ligand. So we have taken the example of morphine, which is a opioid analgesic at a mu receptor. Acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter at a muscarinic receptor. Now we'll discuss the antagonist. What is mean by antagonist, or how will you define antagonist? Antagonist, they have ability to bind with the receptor, means affinity is plus one. They have ability to bind with the receptor, but they don't have any intrinsic activity. That means intrinsic activity is zero. Intrinsic activity is zero in case of antagonist or neutral antagonist. Or we can define this antagonist also as it prevents the binding of agonist to its receptor. How will you define antagonist? It prevents binding of agonist to its receptor. That is what is antagonist. Now partial agonist, in case of partial agonist, affinity is plus one or minus one. Means they have moderate affinity towards activated receptor. And they have intrinsic activity, that is submaximal intrinsic activity. So what is the difference between agonist and partial agonist? This agonist we can call as a full agonist and this agonist as a partial agonist. So this full agonist will produce a maximum response at a therapeutic dose. This partial agonist will produce this much response, whatever may be the concentration, it will produce this much response, and this full agonist will produce this much response. Why is it so? Because this partial agonist is having submaximal intrinsic activity, whatever may be the concentration of the drug. It will produce this much response because of submaximal intrinsic activity. And examples of the partial agonist like tramadol or pentazocine, these are the examples of partial agonist. And clinical significance of partial agonists like tramadol or pentazocine, they are safe drugs. Why they are safe drug? Because whatever the concentration, they will produce this much response because of submaximal intrinsic activity. Now, this inverse agonist, they have ability to bind with the receptor. That means affinity is plus one. And intrinsic activity is minus one. That means they will produce exactly opposite effect to that of agonist. It will produce exactly opposite effect to that of agonist. For example, we'll take example of benzodiazepine over here. We'll take example of benzodiazepine. This benzodiazepine will bind to the benzodiazepine receptors. Benzodiazepine will bind to the benzodiazepine receptors. And here, bicuculine will also bind to the benzodiazepine receptors. This benzodiazepine will produce anticonvulsant effect. This benzodiazepine will produce anti-anxiety effect. And it will also produce sedative effect by binding with this benzodiazepine receptor. This bicuculine, by binding with the benzodiazepine receptor, it will produce exactly opposite effect of that. Exactly opposite effect of that means it will produce convulsion, it will produce anxiety, and it will produce arousal. What does that mean? This inverse agonist, they have affinity to bind with the drug. They have affinity to bind with the receptor. And they have exactly, they will produce exactly opposite effect of that agonist. Means this benzodiazepine, when binds to the benzodiazepine receptor, it acts as anticonvulsant, anti-anxiety effect and sedative effect. But when bicuculine, when binds to this benzodiazepine receptor, it will produce exactly opposite effect of that agonist. Likewise, it will produce convulsions, anxiety and arousal. That's it.